I got broads in the line, just to be in the family. Credit cards in the scammers, hitting the licks in the family. Legacies, family, waiting to see them like a panda.
Welcome back, everyone, to the channel. And today, we've got some more Wake Forest Demon Deacons Dynasty action here for you. As today, we have a recruiting special. Under Reggie Bell, there is going to be some new changes, of course. So, with one of the main changes, we're going to be bringing in the top prospects the Deacons will be looking at to a little quote-unquote camp every year at the Wake Forest practice facility, and we'll have them go up against our starters. So we'll have the top recruits we're going after going up against guys like Kasong Bassey, Justin Chernod, and all those guys. And we'll also do a defensive and offensive. So we're going to have like 12 guys. So we're just going to do like a normal recruiting special that you see from other guys. So first of all, let's start off with probably the most intriguing prospect here. And that is Tanner Brunson. As you can see, he is a quarterback making a phenomenal throw to another prospect in Derek Thornberry there. Now he's going to take off using his legs. He is just a high school freshman. So he's going to have a lot to work on. He's from Irwin, North Carolina, the same high school as another prospect we're going after in Anquan Good. And Brunson, he's a freshman, so he's going to have a ton of time to develop, and he's one of the top prospects going forward in the 2023 high school class. As you can see, he is very mobile, and he can step up in the pocket. He's patient. He can make very good throws. He has a very strong arm. There really isn't much to dislike about Tanner Brunson. He has a ton of upside, and he makes smart throws and smart decisions. As you can see, a projected 4-star, little undersized at 5'10", 170. Once again, he is just a freshman, so he's going to have a lot of growing to do. And next up, we have a 5-star, probably the biggest guy we want this year, in running back Carlos Stanford, 6'2", 249. He is a pretty big guy. So as you can see, he can do the work in the receiving game. As you can see, going on a little wheel route, making a guy miss and falling forward for an extra couple yards. And then here you can see the same thing pretty much. He's gonna go out for a little route, and he's gonna get open, and he's gonna just use his speed. He's kind of a mix of a power back and a speed back. I really love his ability. He's going to be a great get for us, assuming we get him, as we are one of the top teams. And as you can see here, showing off his ability in the running game, just finding the hole and getting through it, is once again same play, pretty much the same exact thing. He's going to break tackles, and he's going to use his power aspect in this part. So once again, same play, he's just gonna run over a defender. And there's a ton of talent within Carlos Stanford. Next year, when Cade Carney's gone, we're gonna need another running back. Christian Beale Smith probably won't cut it. Next up, we have another running back, an athlete in Derek Robinson. Scouted him, he looks like a running back, he looks more like a receiving back, kind of like Theo Riddick in the Lions series was. You could probably use him in that role, maybe a bigger role. As you can see, great receiver here. As see, he's just gonna get open here, and I believe that's Tanner Brunson. He's gonna make a phenomenal throw, but Robinson would get into the end zone. He is a very good, very talented back. We could use him as a running back. We could line him up as a receiver. I see him coming up as a backup running back, assuming we do get Carlos Stanford. Robinson has a ton of upside. I really like his potential. He is a +7 gym. He's a 4-star. Anyways, next up we have a 5-star, the 3rd-ranked wide receiver, Anquan Good. I mentioned him when we were talking about Tanner Brunson. Same high school Brunson goes to, from Irwin, North Carolina as well. As you can see, that is Brunson looking for Good, and Good running a phenomenal route. He has a ton of speed here. As you can see, Dom Mariotti is a quarterback. We're going to get into him later. So you can see Good using his speed, and he is a phenomenal route runner. As you can see, just breaking off the defenders and making a nice catch and using his speed to get into the end zone. I really love this guy. He's a guy we really want to have to boost our receiving core with Donovan Green and Nolan Grolks, two freshmen coming back, and just adding Good could make this receiving core a whole lot stronger and could potentially make it a really good core for the future. And another wide receiver who I'm really high on, Derek Thornberry, 3-star, 43rd ranked wide receiver, a little undersized, but he is blazing fast. He has blazing speed, and he is a phenomenal route runner as well. The guys we're going after, the receivers, are amazing at route running, as we have two other guys that we're going to look at in AJ Jackson and Trent Terry, who are both phenomenal route runners. As you can see, Thornberry using his speed to get off the defenders. Now, just mentioned AJ Jackson, he's a projected 3-star, kind of more of a physical guy than good, and Thornberry, he's from Salt Lake City, Utah, so this could be kind of a difficult guy to get. He's a high school junior. AJ Jackson, a phenomenal route runner here. In this next play, he does get open, but he just makes a mistake and drops the pass. There were a couple of plays where he just dropped a wide open pass, so I'm kind of concerned about his catching ability, but other than that, he seems to be a very good wide receiver. As you can see here, breaking off the defenders, and then he's just going to truck over a guy and get into the end zone. I believe he got into the end zone on that play. As you can see here, Mariotti putting the ball on a perfect line, and Jackson just goes up and makes a catch in here. When Jackson is covered, he goes up and makes a phenomenal catch. So Jackson showing that one of his weaknesses that appeared can be a strength. Now I have Jabari Cage III, a 3-star, 85th ranked quarterback. Very, very big guy. He's kind of balanced. He can run, but he can also pass, as you can see, running around to the right side before getting tripped up by Tywan Frazier, who we'll go over later. We didn't really get much film from Cage, but we have been scouting him a lot all over the country lately. You can see making a beautiful pass to AJ Jackson, and once again just floating that one into Jackson. We already saw this play when we went over Jackson, but there it is again. As I said before, Cage, we've been scouting him a lot. We're in the lead for him, if I had to guess. So he's definitely going to be a really good backup for Sam Hartman, assuming we do get Cage. Now, another projected 3-star in the high school class of 2022, a high school sophomore, is Dom Mariotti. We saw him a lot earlier throwing balls to good Derek Thornberry, AJ Jackson, and we'll see him here throwing some balls to Trent Terry as well as Mariotti. He's bounce guy. He can run the football and he can pass the football pretty well, as you can see, putting a phenomenal throw right in the hands of Anquan Good. As I'm very high on Mariotti, so he could potentially be another great backup until Hartman leaves, or no, he'd actually start when Hartman would leave, because Hartman would be a senior when Mariotti would be recruited. So we could potentially have this guy be our quarterback of the future once Sam Hartman leaves. Next up, we have a wide receiver in Trent Terry, 4-star, 8th wide receiver, 6'5", 235. He is a big guy. He's a physical guy who's going to go up and catch balls. That is what he is made to do. 6'5", a huge frame, and he's going to go up and catch balls. That is what he's made to do, but he's also a great route runner, as you can see, breaking off the defenders and getting into the end zone here. So now I have Jabari Cage as a quarterback, just throwing it up, and Terry, he's going to truck a guy, and then he's going to truck another one using his physicality to gain an extra around 20 yards, or not 20 yards, like 5 or 10 yards. That could be key in maybe third down situations where we're going to need that extra 3 yards. So now we move to the defensive side of the ball, and a defensive tackle in Tywan Frazier, 6'5", 295, a 3-star from Winston-Salem. As you can see here, he's just going to get off the block and cause a lot of pressure here. And now, once again, he's going to get off the block, and this time he's going to wrap up Tanner Brunson and slam him to the ground. I love his game, especially as an interior D lineman. He is huge. He's 6'5", 295. He can go up against a lot of blockers, and he could be a potential mismatch with his speed, as he shows there, going to the outside and bringing some pressure, helping and bringing Brunson down, as you can see, getting off the block and providing some pressure here. And now, once again, just slamming Tanner Brunson on this play. Now we have an outside linebacker, a 4-star, in at Tyler Jackson from Fort Defiance, Arizona, the 10th outside linebacker in the country. He is a 80 overall. He's like a plus 6 GM, I believe. Not many people were going after, so we jumped in. As you can see here, he's making a big impact early on. As you can see, dropping back into coverage, and when Brunson takes off, he's going to go up and make the sure tackle. Now we have Jackson. He's just going to come in reading the play like a book and getting Brunson in the backfield, making him go nowhere. Now we have Jamal McKenzie, a 4-star, 6-ranked strong safety, 6'3", 206. So he's a pretty solid size for a strong safety. As you have McKenzie coming on a blitz here, causing pressure and forcing a throwaway. Now McKenzie again, this time he's going to force a sack. So McKenzie, when he blitzes from that strong safety position, it's kind of tough for him not to get a sack. He's very talented. I love his skill set. And as you can see, blitzing and forcing a throwaway. And once again, he's going to blitz, but this time he's going to bring Brunson down. And once again, we just see how good of a blitzer Jamal McKenzie is. And now we're going to go to the update part of the video. We're just going to show you all what people are going after position by position and then eventually the board. So at quarterback, we only have one. That is Jabari Cage III. We went over him in the recruiting special. One in the lead for him by a lot. At running back, we've got a four-star and a 5-star in John Thomas and Carlos Stanford. At fullback, we have Eric Haley, and at wide receiver, the three main guys we're going after, Derek Thornberry, Anquan Good, and Trent Terry. We're behind on Good and Terry, but hopefully we can make that up. And then the other two guys, Josh Gangers and Matt McDaniel, we're just going to try to get them for depth pieces, probably redshirt them. At tight end, we have Lance Spurlock from Bismarck, North Dakota. He seems really interested in us, 72 overall. And we have the lead on him by a lot at tackle. We're going to need to replace a lot of offensive linemen this year, but we're not really recruiting that well with O-lineman. Justin Ralph is the only real guy we have, and we aren't in the lead for him, so that's going to be a tough get for us. Corey Hayford, an offensive guard who was interested in us from the get-go, and have a defensive end who we just put on the board. That is Blake Bullock. We're 160 points behind. He's a 4-star, very solid end. Now a defensive tackle, we have Tywan Frazier and Mike Stevens. For whatever reason, Frazier wants to go to Northwestern. I guess he just wants to freeze to death up there. And now we go to outside linebacker. We have Titus Smart and Tyler Jackson. Jackson, we went over him in the recruiting special. He's one of those low lock gems. Now at middle linebacker, we're just going to get some depth with Brandon Richards. Cornerback, we have Josh Jude. We're not in the race at all. Probably going to dump him off the board after this week. Maybe we can get him. I highly doubt it. Free safety, nobody. And at strong safety, we have Jamal McKenzie, who we talked about in the recruiting special, and PJ Collins, who I just added on the board. And an athlete, we have one, Derek Robinson. We're up by 610 points over Texas and Tennessee. He's very good, as I said in the recruiting special. Hopefully he can maybe potentially play as a running back. Maybe he can play receiver. We'll see that when we get into the offseason, if we get Robinson. But anyways, he is a guy I really, really want on this team. So now I'm just going to scroll through, and I'm just going to show you guys my board and how everything's going. But anyways, guys, that'll wrap it up for me. Thank you guys so much for watching. Remember to smash the like button, hit that subscribe button. This, as always, is Royal and Poison, and I'm out. Peace.